Alright, for this video, we'll be solving another sample problem for implementing a safety factor or allowable stress in designing simple connections. So, here we have a problem. Ito yung problem statement. Problem statement states that we have a 50 kilogram flower pot. It's suspended from wires A, B, and BC, which have diameters of 1.5 millimeters and 2 millimeters respectively. So, magkaiba yung diameter ng AB at BC natin. Mas maliit yung diameter ng AB compared sa BC. If the wires have a normal failure stress of 350 megapascals, determine the factor of safety of each wire. So, pareho sila ng failure stress, 350 megapascals. So, more or less, itong dalawang wires na ito ay gawa sa parehong material, no? Since pareho sila ng failure stress. So ngayon, ang required sa atin is kunin yung FS or yung factor of safety. Given lang tayo ng 350 megapascals as the failure stress. So medyo baliktad ito ng mga, yung naunang nabigay natin na sample problem, medyo baliktad ito, no? Kasi dati, given na yung sample factor of safety, ngayon naman is yung factor of safety yung kukunin. So, pag i-isolate natin yung point na to, no? So, kunin natin yung FBD or yung free body diagram. Meron tayong dalawang forces na tension from AB and BC, no? Caused by two wires. So, yung weight natin is downward tapos sinihila siya upward ng dalawang wires. And thus, pag i-cut natin yung sections nitong dalawang members, lalabas yung dalawang tension forces na FAB and FBC. Okay? So, again, recall that the equation for factor of safety is this one. It's just the ratio of stress fail divided by stress allowable. So, we're given with the stress fail, which is 350 megapascals for each wire. And then, ang gagawin lang natin ngayon para makuha yung FS is kukunin na lang natin yung allowable stress ng each wire, no? Considering the weight that's they're both carrying. So weight is 50 kilograms times the acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81 meter per second squared. Ang weight natin in Newton is equivalent to 490.5 Newtons. Okay? So ang gagawin natin dito, first is statics. So ito na yung free body diagram natin. Ito yung angles ng dalawang forces with respect to the horizontal. So W is now 490.5 Newtons. So statics, summation of forces along y and x. Kasi pag point or equilibrium at a particle, kung maalala niyo sa statics, walang moment, di ba? Kasi ang tawag natin sa forces na to ay concurrent forces. They all act at the same or mag-meet sila or mag-concur sa isang point. Ibig sabihin, walang moment or walang rotation. So magagamit lang natin dito is equilibrium along x and y or yung equilibrium in translation. So, summation of forces along x, dalawang forces lang available sa along the x-axis. Meron kang x component ng FBC tsaka x component ng FAB. So, x component ng FBC is just cosine 45, di ba? Kasi adjacent over hypotenuse. And then, similarly with FAB, adjacent over hypotenuse lang, cosine 30. Tapos negative yung FAB kasi papunta siya sa direction na negative, okay? To the left. Ito naman to the right, so positive. Equals 0. So, tatawagin natin yung equation 1, okay? And then, summation of forces along y, meron tayong tatlo, no? Tatlong forces along y. We have the y components of FBC and FAB. And then, we have the downward force due to the weight of the flower pot. Okay? So, pag y naman, sine kasi opposite. Similar with this one, opposite ng theta, sine theta lang. No? So, sine 45, sine 30. So, parehong positive yung y components ng FBC kasi parehong upward. No? So, yan. And then, you have the negative 490 kasi downward naman yung W. Okay? So, upward forces are positive, downward forces are negative. Tatawagan natin itong equation 2. So, meron na tayong two equations to announce. Two unknowns because we have FBC and FAB, and then you have two equations. So, pwede na nating ma-solve either unahin ba natin yung FBC or FAB? So unahin muna natin yung FAB, no? So we are going to express FBC in terms of FAB. So from this equation, equation 1, makukuha natin yung FBC as square root of 6 divided by 2 of FAB. So ito na yung relationship bali ng FBC in terms of FAB. So dito lang yung kinuha, no? Nilipat dito, tapos dinivide ng cosine 45. Okay? So itong value na to, yung FBC equals square root of 6 over 2 FAB, ito naman yung isa-substitute natin sa equation 2. Giving us this one, no? So substitute natin yan sa FBC. So magiging square root of 6 over 2 na yung FBC natin, no? So makikita natin dito, sa equation na to, isa na lang yung unknown natin, which is FAB. And then, pwede nating i-add to, no? Square root of 6 over 2 times sine 45 plus sine 30 equals 490.5. Magiging positive na kasi nililipat natin. Nilipat na natin sa right side. Okay? So, FAB equals 359.07. This one, FAB. And then, ibabalik natin dito sa equation natin. So, 359.07 times square root of 6 over 2. Makuha natin ang FBC na 439.77 newton. So ngayon meron na tayong internal forces, no? So ito yung internal forces ng wires BC and AB. Okay? So ngayon, since meron tayong internal forces, makukuha na natin yung stresses dun sa ating wires, no? Yun yung allowable stresses natin, no? So allowable stress in AB, gagamitin natin yung FAB na nakuha kanina, and then yung given area na AB. So given ang diameter, and then it's cylindrical wire because given as diameter. So 359.07 newton divided by the area, which is pi over 4 d square. Okay, and then we have 203.19 megapascals. So ito na yung allowable stress ng ating wire since it is based on the given load na W, yung weight ng ating flower pot. So ang allowable stress naman in BC, so BC actually ito, no? This should be BC. Oops. This should be BC. Okay. So the allowable stress for BC is 439.77 newton. Tapos ito yung area now. So mas malaki yung BC, 2 mm. Tapos ito yung force given, or na yung nakuha natin kanina, we'll have 139.98 megapascals. So, ito yung allowable stresses for the wires AB and BC respectively. So, yung equation natin kanina na FS is the ratio of stress fail divided by stress allowable. Meron na tayong both fail and ito, no, given na fail, tapos meron tayong dalawang allowable stresses, makukuha natin yung FS for each wire. So, unahin natin yung AB. We have stress fail is 350 divided by allowable, which is 203.19 megapascals. You will have an FS of 1.722, or a factor of safety of 1.722. Sa BC naman, we will have 350 divided by this one, the computed allowable stress, 139.98 megapascals. So, factor of safety is 2.5. Okay, so mas malaki yung factor of safety ng FSBC compared sa ating FSA. B. So, ganun lang, no? Binaliktad lang natin actually yung process, no? So, pero medyo hindi to siya hindi naman realistic, no? Pero less usual siyang nangyayari sa actual kasi yun nga, mas conventionally inuuna talaga natin mag-specify ng factor of safety, no? Bago mag-design ng area. But anyway, yun, no? Para lang maintindihan pa natin yung concept. So, ganitong problem yung binigay natin para mas malaro pa natin yung mga equations. And then, yun, mas maintindihan natin yung application ng factor of safety. And then, dun sa design ng simple connections or anywhere, no, kahit hindi simple connections, yun, ito yung concept ng factor of safety. Okay? So, yun. Thank you again for joining us today. So, see you again sa ating next na video.